gives on certain potentials in the ecclesiastical or church view, that the church sets aside Sundays to remember events of the past, just as on this Sunday it is asked to hold memory and to bring to mind the Holy Fathers from the great Seventh Council. If we were to ask the average Orthodox, why was that council so important? What took place? Why should we remember those individuals? The average Orthodox might say the council was about the icons, which it was. But in reality, the council spoke of a much deeper and richer theology. It spoke about Jesus Christ, like all of the councils. If you begin with the first and go through the seven great councils, each of them speak about Jesus Christ, about his personhood, his identity, who he was and why he came into this world. From the first council, we know that he is not a creature of God, but he is one of the Trinity, one who helps create. He is the Logos who was in the beginning. And in the following councils, we learn about his nature and his wills. We understand that his totality as an individual and as a person. And the last great council came to seal, or to remind us of all of those teachings of the past, and that Christ came to earth, and he appeared as a human being, so that he might transfigure and change our humanity, so that we might become God-like, and that we could leave this world and ascend into the heavens, and be with him and the Father. It was to teach us that Christ was a real person. And he came and he was crucified upon a cross. He gave his life for us and for the whole world. And the council reaffirmed that we should understand him and his teachings through these sacred images, which we call icons, whether they be mosaics or they be painted, they be written with ink and other methods, either on paper or on wood. But we should put the teachings of Christ and the truth of who he was, so that people might understand that he was the one who entered Jerusalem, and he's the one who's proclaimed to be the resurrection, just as he raised Lazarus from the dead. The council came to assure us that everything that had been taught and had been given us was the truth. But the truth isn't enough to remain in the past and in the pages of time. The truth of the church and the truth of Christ exists even to this day. And that is why the teachings of the council are important for us as a community. Because we are the ones who come into the church and we venerate the icons. We're the ones who come into the church and offer our prayers to the Virgin Mary and to the saints. We're the ones who kneel before the holy relics and ask for God to send his grace. So the teachings of the council were not only a theological statement to be understood by the mind, but they were also a statement for humanity, for us as the people of God, how we are to live, how we are to worship. But they were even more than that. They spoke to us of who we are as people. Sometimes in our lives as Christians and people of this world, we forget who we are. We think that we've become the creator and forget that we are the created. We think that we've become God-like and so great and omnipotent and omniscient
invites us to believe in the resurrection, to know that even though Adam and Eve sinned, there was forgiveness for them. That for you and for me, there's always forgiveness when we repent. He wants to remind us that all we have to do is ask for His love and His mercy, to appeal to Him to seek His grace, and He shall raise us up from the tombs as He raises up Eve and Adam and all of those who find themselves in Hades. The teaching of the council then was about us people today. Too often we worry about the wrong things in our lives as human beings and even as Christians. And I tell you that only one thing is necessary, as Jesus Christ said to Mary and to Martha. Don't concern yourself with the ways of the world and its challenges and its noises and its situations, but rather sit at the feet of Christ and listen to His word and find the message of salvation in Him as in His truth. Today, when you leave this church, remember that the council was about you because it's about icons, and you are the living icons of Christ. You are created in His image and in His likeness. The council is about us and our lives as people in this world with our challenges. And may we go forth into the world with hope in the cross and our belief in the resurrection, that death and sin and evil have been conquered and shall be overcome. For upon that old rugged cross, our Lord gave His life. And our Creator came to this world to redeem us, which He did. If we believe and if we accept and we confess Him,